So this is a remarkable fact about this Q-learning rule, and that is if we start Q-hat off pretty much anywhere, and then we update it according to the rule that we talked about, Q for when we see a transition, S-A-R, S-prime, then we update S-A, the Q-value for S-A, we move it alpha of the way towards R plus gamma max A of the, well, basically the Q-value of the state S-prime, then as long as we do that, then this estimate, this Q hat, SA, goes to QSA, the actual solution to the Bellman equation. And I write this with an exclamation mark because it's like, it's one line of code. It's one line of code. Like, how could you not just go out and write this right now? But the let me just to finish is this is only true if we actually visit SA infinitely often. So, you know, that's an important caveat that for this to actually hold true, for you to really converge to this, the solution, it has to run for a long time. It has to visit all state action pairs. The learning rates have to be updated the way that we talked about before. The next states need to be drawn from the actual transition probabilities, but that's cool if we actually are learning in some actual environment. And the rewards need to be drawn from the reward function. So this isn't so problematic. This is a little bit problematic, but it is still very reassuring, this idea that we have the right form of an update rule so that the thing that we converge to is the actual optimal solution to the MDP.
Cool. And we just have to wait till the heat death of the universe or infinity, and then we're done.
Yeah.